Hello friends, continuing our videos on power plant, today we are presenting a video on a boiler follow mode. In the earlier video, we have discussed coordinated master control. Okay. So before we go deep in a video, I will give you some terms which we will be discussing. The first term is BLI. Here BLI stands for boiler load index. The BLI is a term which is very synonymous to steam flow, the main steam flow. So BLI is a main steam flow to the HP turbine. And the other one is a EHTC. As we have discussed in our previous video, we will give you information about EHTC in our upcoming videos. But for now, I'm giving you just the full form of this one. And this is the electro hydraulic controller. This system controller controls the turbine. So friends, as the name suggests, in the boiler follow mode, the boiler will follow the turbine. This is a very easy to get that in the boiler follow mode, the boiler will follow. Okay, and boiler will follow what? Boiler will follow turbine. Okay, so the controllers, we have a three controllers here. You can see the first one is a unit controller, which is a main control, which will control both one. Okay, the main block of the CM, this control. Other one is a boiler master, which will control the boiler. And the third one is a turbine control, master controller, which will control the turbine. The unit controller in boiler follow mode is different from CMC's unit controller in respect that key in the CMC mode, there was the output of the unit controller was a feed forward signal that was fed to the boiler master. But here the output is a megawatt error. The unit controller is having two inputs. The first one is a load set point and second one is a LDC. Load set point is given by the controller from the unit control desk. It is always equal to the actual load which we are supposed to run, the demand. The megawatt error is the difference between the actual load and the load set point. So this is a value which is a proportional to the megawatt error value. And here this value, megawatt error value, is fed to the turbine master controller. Instead of this value fed in the boiler master controller in the CMC mode. Okay, so the next block is the boiler master. We have discussed the unit controller where there is a one input load set point and the output is megawatt error. A megawatt error will be later fed to the turbine master controller. So now coming to boiler master block. The function of a boiler master is quite similar to the CMC mode. It controls the boiler. Okay. The boiler master is having three inputs. This one, two, and three. The first one is a feed forward signal. As I have told you in a previous video, feed forward signal is an anticipatory value. Okay. So we predict that what will happen in the future, and we will generate a variable in the present and we will feed it to our controller so that it can anticipate that what will happen and it can overcome the deviations that will happen in future. Okay, so that the control will be very smooth. Okay, there will be no deviations to die out the deviations. So the first one is a feed forward signal, and this is the steam flow BLI. As I told you in the starting of the video, so this signal is a steam flow, which is known as a boiler load index. The second input is a MS pressure set point. So MS pressure set point is a set point which a controller wants to maintain. Okay, and the actual pressure is the what at the unit is running at, actual MS pressure. On receiving these three inputs, the boiler master will give out the output, and that will be in the form of the fuel flow and the air flow. As I told you earlier, boiler master is fed with a curve. This is supplied by the OEM. So in the curve that I have shown here, depending on the values of the input, the values of the output are decided, and that is fed to this controller. Okay, and these can be changed as per the controller's choice and as per the unit stability to achieve the certain parameters, how fast you want to achieve and how correctly how you want to achieve it. Okay, so next controller is a turbine master controller. As I told you, the turbine master controller generates output which will be fed as an input to the EHTC, electrohydraulic controller. Okay, so turbine master has a one input, and that one input is a megawatt error signal that we are getting from the unit controller. The megawatt error signal is a proportional to the actual megawatt error, that is the actual difference between the actual load and the load set point. Okay, so based on that value, that is a proportional value. It might not be the same difference, but it will be a proportional value. And the output of turbine master controller is a ESTC input. In the boiler follow mode, as the name suggests, I have told you earlier that boiler will follow turbine. So turbine will be first to act on the input. Okay, as the input will be received, turbine will be the first to act. So it happens like this, that when you get a load set point, unit controller will generate a megawatt error. That megawatt error is fed to this turbine master controller, and turbine master controller, based on a megawatt error, okay, if it is a positive, means this actual load is less than load set point. Okay, and if it is negative, then it is actual load is greater than the load set point. Okay, so that it will be the polarity of the megawatt error. So based on a megawatt error, turbine master controller will give the ESTC input. Okay, and if it is a positive megawatt error positive, then the ESTC input will be increased, and if it is negative, then the ESTC input will be decreased. So our first process action is taken by a turbine master controller, but in this all process, the boiler was not touched. Okay, there is nothing going on the boiler, but because there is no signal going to the boiler, feed forward signal, so boiler is maintaining what it was maintaining before this whole sequence, before getting the load set point input. Okay, assuming that we have given a load, we have changed that load set point at T time. Okay, so boiler master will maintain its state, which was at T minus 1 time. Okay, so now the ESTC input has been increased or decreased based on the load set point and actual load. So the load will increase. Okay, so we will get a desired load, but as you know, friends, as a load will increase, this will lead to MS pressure falling. Okay, also as the load will increase, we will get that the steam flow will also increase. So friends, here I am taking the case that when the ESTC input will increase, please mind that. Okay, we can have another case where ESTC input will decrease, but I am taking a case of where ESTC input will increase. So ESTC input will increase, the load will increase, actual load will increase, okay, and that will lead to the MS pressure falling, and the steam flow will also increase, because if when the steam flow will increase, then only the load will increase. Okay, so we also know it by the BLI. Okay, so now when the steam flow will increase, this feed forward signal, as the steam flow increases, this feed forward signal is fed to the this boiler master, because when the load will increase, the first thing that we'll see, that first parameter between the MS pressure and the steam flow, the first parameter that will change is the steam flow, because the steam will gush into the HP turbine and it will increase the load. And thereafter, as the steam flow starts increasing and the load, okay, then we will see the fall in MS pressure. So the first point that will change is the steam flow. So that's why we have used that feed forward signal as the steam flow. Okay, so as the load will increase, the feed forward signal, that is the steam flow, will start to increase, and MS pressure point will be same, and actual MS pressure will be almost changing, but it will be changing slowly, because the effect of the MS pressure will be come into effect after few minutes. Okay, it will decrease slowly. Okay, so getting a feed forward signal as fast as it can, the boiler master will start acting, and therefore it will what, combining the effect of the actual pressure also falling, and this difference between the MS pressure point and actual pressure decreasing, it will increase the firing and the airflow, because it has to maintain the MS pressure, so it will increase the fuel flow and it will increase the airflow, and that's how it will achieve the desired MS set point. Okay, and the boiler will be stabilized. So friends, we have looked into the functioning of the boiler follow mode, and how these all blocks will work, how the turbine will come first and a boiler will act secondly. Okay, now what is the benefit of the boiler follow mode? In this mode, what is the pros of this mode? That you will get unit load fast. Okay, you will be able to maintain your schedule generation as per the grid. It will lead to the stability of the grid also. Stability of grid. By stability of grid, I mean that the load which you are required to pump in the grid, it will maintain.